Hi, welcome you all to Sri Lectures YouTube channel. So in this video, we will see the virtual lab experiment on load characteristics of DC shunt motor. It is developed by IIT Roorkee in associated with MHRD, Government of India initiative. So now we will move on to virtual lab. So the procedure is like previous experiment. So simply type VLab on Google search, and first link we will get the VLab.co.in. In that, click on electrical engineering. In electrical engineering, we have different link. So in that, we will click on IIT Roorkee. So in that we have the list of experiment. So but our experiment is load characteristics of DC shunt generator. Simply click on this. So the aim of our experiment is to study the load characteristics of DC shunt generator and draw the internal characteristics and internal external characteristics under different loading condition. So this is the our main aim of our this experiment. So now simply click on simulation, and here we have pop-up procedure. So I'll click on this, we get the circuit connection and procedure details. So for simulation, we directly move on to simulation page. Simply click this. This is the different component used in load characteristics of DC shunt generator. MCB is the supply terminal, starter, 3-point starter, terminal LFA, and two ammeters, 1 to 20 and 2 to 20 ampere range, and two voltmeter ranges from 1 to 230 and 2 to, sorry. So here range is 20 ampere, this is ammeter 1, this is ammeter 2, 20 ampere range. This is voltmeter 1, 230 volt range, and voltmeter 2, 230 volt range. And if we have the lamp load, we have around 10 lamps, and this is the motor, and this is the generator, this is the observation table. So now we will connect the circuit corresponding to our experiment load characteristics. So first simply connect positive positive terminal of MCB to ammeter, then negative terminal is connected to A2 of motor, negative terminal is connected to A2 of motor, another one terminal is connected to directly connected to negative of voltmeter, and plus is directly connected to plus sign, and the next connection so L is directly connected to ammeter positive terminal. So L is directly connected to ammeter 1 negative terminal, and F is directly connected to Z1 ammeter field motor field winding, and A is directly connected to A1, that is motor armature, and A1 A2 are simply short circuited, that is A2 and Z2 directly short circuited. And L1 is directly connected to voltmeter positive, directly connected to voltmeter positive, and L2 is connected to A2 of generator, and A2 and Z2 are short circuited. Then Z2 is connected to voltmeter negative, and both A1 and A2 connected to ammeter positive. A1 and Z1 is connected to ammeter positive. Now simply check on connection. So correct connection. So we will switch on the supply. And then switch on the supply. The motor is running. So our experiment is load test. So for that we need to turn on the number of load step by step. First I will add one load. So here initially the reading of all the meter and voltmeters are zero. So now I will add one load. So automatically all the meter give the reading. But our main aim is to find the load characteristics. So we will take these two readings. That is generator side ammeter, generator side current rating and voltage rating. Simply tabulate this value. So add, simply click on add to take the reading. Then we will turn on 3 lamp and add that reading. So 3.2 and 208. While adding the load, so small drop in voltage. So then 4 lamp. Then add that value. Then 5 lamp. Then directly move on to 6 lamp. So we get 7 ampere and 198, and 8 lamp, 10.2 and 104, and for 9 lamp we get 11 and 179, for 10 lamp we get 12.7 current and 176 voltage. So this is the reading corresponding to load characteristics. So now we will plot the graph. By simply click on this, we get the graph corresponding to load current. Graph is corresponding to load current and load voltage. So while increasing the current load, automatically current increase, we have small drop in terminal voltage or generator voltage. This is due to armature reaction and resistance drop. We all studied in theory. So now simply click on this print. We get the result in single PDF. So for that is used for further consideration. This is all about load characteristics of DC shunt generator. So now the next experiment will be on next video will be on virtual lab experiment on open circuit and short circuit test on single phase transformer. Thank you for watching. Thank you.